with Tyler and my friend Crystal. We're gonna cut Tyler's hair where it's kind of short here on the sides and spiky up here on the top. You like spiky, Tyler?
Yeah.
Spicy?
Spiky.
Spiky.
Okay. We're gonna start with a two. A guard number two. And we're just gonna go around his ears with that. Maybe like halfway up. Okay, let's turn you this way. Just go halfway up the hair.
She's cutting a lot of hair off, Tyler. Looks good.
And I like to go every direction with the clippers, especially if you have a guard, you can get little lines. So seriously, you can just go this way, that way, up, just go every way to make sure you blend any lines.
So you can't mess it up, really?
You can't mess it up because you have a guard, so you can go every way.
Where is the guard?
So this is the guard right here.
Okay.
This plastic guy.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead and look down for me, Tyler. And then if you want it really nice and close on the neck, you have them look down.
Okay.
And see, he has these little cowlicks, which aren't bad, but if you have a cowlick that grows upward, maybe like, so this grows like more to the side this way. So I go against the grain like this, like that way. Go ahead and look down for me one more time, Tyler. Good job. And then you can do the same thing, just go in every direction. But if you have cowlicks, which is super common, right here and right here, and if they grow up, then I actually go down on it because it's against the growth. Okay, and then turn you this way. Let's go this side. You're doing great, Tyler.
It's looking so much more cleaned up.
Looks so good.
Yeah.
Can hold their head for stability. They won't mind. You can lift the hair up with your thumb if you're motivated enough, and then let the hair fall into it, and that's more, gives it a more clean, even cut too. And you can see it a little bit better. Make sure you get all those little straggly hairs. It's easy to miss hairs. And then depending on the clippers that you have, if you have an adjuster, this moves up half. So this is two, and this is 2.5.
Okay.
So then you can go through and just blend this little line with the 2.5. There's lots of ways you can do it, but this is the way I do it.
Okay.
And it depends on my mood. Look down for me. Sometimes I start with the longest, and then I go down. But we'll just start with the shortest.
Sounds good.
Good. Okay. So now we're gonna put on this three guard. So we started with two, 2.5. Now this is a three.
Okay. So you did a lot of hair with a two, and then 2.5 was just blending in.
Blending in this just to prep for the three.
Okay.
So then it depends on what you want to do. I blend this ledge with scissors, but if you're doing it at home, not a lot of people know how to do that. So you can go through with like a four even on this curve of this receding line.
Okay.
And go in with a four and just get this line so it's not so puffy right here.
Okay.
I go through with scissors, but you can do it with your clippers.
Okay.
So I'm gonna do a three right now, and if you're at home, you can blend this with a four.
Okay.
If you're going short on top.
Okay.
Okay, so here we go. Let's get right here. Ooh, looks good.
Thank you. so you don't even have to wet the hair?
No, you need to do it dry.
Okay.
For this part. When I cut with scissors, I do it wet.
Okay.
When I do clippers, you can't really clipper hair wet. It's okay. Not going to cut very well.
Okay.
It's definitely not fun wet. So make sure it's clean, but dry.
Okay.
So if it had product in it, I would wash it beforehand.
Okay.
And then dry it and then clipper it.
Stay still, buddy.
Good job, Tyler. You're doing great. Holy cow. You look so still. You're the best 4-year-old I've had in this chair. Usually they're so wiggly. Okay, here we go. So see this ledge?
Yep.
If you're at home, you would just go through with a 4.
Okay.
And just take it and just go right on that.
Okay.
And I'm just going to love this. But I'm going to do it with scissors. Especially because he has cowlicks that we're working around.
So well, then not, you can show us both
it's
ways.
It's not completely clean cut to yeah. just do clippers with okay. cowlicks.
Yeah, he has a lot of cowlicks.
You have to kind of adjust with cowlicks. So he has cowlicks here and here. It kind of like pushes it in this whirl. Super fun. I might even have one. It bunches into like a tail right here, so okay. we might even have one, like 2 right here.
Way to go, Tyler! Lots of cowlicks.
And then his hair actually pushes super, super flat and straight.
Yes, it does. Yes.
And so the picture that you showed me, you want it up.
Yes.
And either way, you can style it that way.
Okay.
With this, but I'll cut it in both ways.
Okay.
For days that you don't want to style it.
Okay. Sounds good.
Okay, so now this is where we wet. So at the top, I'll go around the ears after
okay.
with trimmers.
Yeah, I forgot to tell you that his hair does fall forward.
Yes,
definitely.
I can see that.
Try to.
You need some really strong product.
Yes.
But look how cute it is when you push it
out.
It
is
like
so cute. You're so handsome, Tyler.
And either, if you're doing it at home too, you maybe don't even have to blend this line. Okay. You can have it overlap. So you
okay.
can do it 2 straight up to oh. this receding
oh, okay.
line.
Uh-huh.
Just and lift this hair up, even clip it up.
Okay.
Do a nice line, clip it up. Do a 2 all the way up, nice and clean. Then lay this over.
Okay.
And that's the style right
okay.
now, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go through and take this corner,
okay.
which you would do yeah, with clippers, but we'll go I'm through sure scissors.
Yeah. All right. Okay. We'll see you. Thank yeah. you.
Yeah. Nice.
It got really quiet all of a sudden.
It's good for us. So this is his cowlick right here, so I'm leaving this a little longer,
okay.
which you wouldn't normally do, but
if there was no cowlick there, you'd want it shorter.
Yes. I understand that not everybody can do this part.
Yeah.
This is how I blend this line. You can also go through with thinning shears and blend it a little bit better. You have to go every direction with the clippers, or else there'll be lines.
Yeah.
Especially with his hair, because it pushes super flat to my neck. Feeling itchy, Tyler? It gets a little itchy. So I wouldn't have to go back and do this if I just did the clippers a little bit longer in every direction and made sure all these lines were blended. Now I have to
okay.
go through with my scissors. But. Okay, so let's turn this way, and let's get this side, and we're just going to cut this corner off, just like the other side. Leave this cowlick a little bit longer, just barely trim that. To help, make sure you just brush with the cowlick, see where it wants to
okay.
lay, and then cut with it. it's gonna lay flat down, so I need to cut that part. If you wanna make sure the sledge is blended all the way, no matter where they turn their head, push it down.
Okay.
Make sure there's no ledge. Or if you're at home, just pick it up. Cut that corner a little bit shorter. Am I talking loud enough?
I think so.
Whispering. Okay. So now that we got those edges blended, you're looking good. Mm-hmm. Let's cut your front. So it's a little bit longer in the picture. So let's start with this, and then you can tell me if you want a shorter.
Okay.
So I lift it up, and I kind of cut it like more rounded.
Okay.
Like not completely straight. It depends on what you're doing, but right now I'm doing it straight and rounded down.
Okay.
And luckily he doesn't have any. Well, he has a calicrator.
Calic number 5. Good job, Tyler. 6, maybe.
So this is like my little trick. So I start with the front, and then I just cut right down the middle just to create a nice even line.
Okay.
I don't know if that makes it more complicated, but you know. So we're gonna angle it up since his calyx. The shorter we go on his calyx, the more his calyx are gonna poke up. So I'm actually doing something I don't usually do, but I cut this front shorter and I'm gonna go longer right here.
Okay.
Normally, on another child, you would do this a little bit shorter and angle it longer in the front.
Okay. So we're backwards.
I'm gonna go vertical this way. And I'm gonna cut a nice line, angling longer to the back. And honestly, I'm not gonna cut that much off these calyx.
Okay.
So just create like a little mohawk effect.
You have a mohawk.
And now you can go through and you have that guard right in the middle.
Okay.
So cut it that same length as that middle on the edges.
That's so cute. I love that.
And rounding down.
Sorry, I didn't know you were going to be working. That's okay. I didn't. Sure, it's like you don't think that you're going to go out of town without fixing this. And I was like,
yeah. You're like, I wasn't going to, but okay.
Like, it's out of control, and I can't, and
we
was trying to see
a shake. Has that nice straight line going. And then as we go to the back, that guard is going to be a little bit higher, so I won't have to cut as much on these corners.
Okay.
And I'm cutting these corners a little longer, same reason.
So Cherie,
to make sure the calyx don't pick, poke straight up.
And Taya, Christy's friend.
Oh, fun. Awesome. Did you meet her? I think you met her at maybe one of the classes.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
Anyway, she's really nice.
Well, good.
You're doing great, Tyler. We're actually almost done. You're a trooper. Trooper.
Where are we staying, Dean? What? Where are we staying? At Mandalay.
Hey. And if you want to check to make sure everything is even,
yeah.
You can also same check place. It vertically this way and make sure it's straight line.
Yeah, the last time you went, I heard it's been kind of weird the last few years, so hopefully it'll be better.
Just to make sure it's in real random long spots.
It's been a little while.
Yeah.
Because it's I'm like, we might as well go.
He's getting a little wiggly.
He's like, I'm done sitting still.
But he's seriously doing
He looks
so
calm.
Good. You're doing so good, bud. Holy cow. So now it's time to ask you if you like that length. Is that too long?
No, I love it. It's great.
Should we leave it kind of like that?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, and then I like to look in a mirror. It's nice to have a mirror because this needs to be blended a little bit more right here. And he has a cowlick, but I think it's better to take it shorter.
Okay.
It's poking up. So we need to just take it off. It's right on that like curve of the head where it's just not going to look good. Oh, that's perfect.
Were you still
in bed?
No,
I'm going to get this a little bit more. The edges are the hardest part, honestly.
Okay.
At home, you're just going to have to spend a lot of time on it. So just lift it up, see that awkward corner. I have to be careful, but I need to cut that. It's not blending as well as I'd like it to. And you can see it a little bit more as it dries, so it's kind of nice to go back around after you spray it.
Okay.
Because now it's drying, you can kind of see what's not blended as much. That's not blended as much as I'd like it. Okay, can you be still like a statue? You're doing so good, Tyler. My goodness. You're doing so good.
What are those called?
They're just thinning shears.
Thinning shears, okay.
So, a little bit of a line, you can blend it a little bit better if you go through and just don't go straight to the scalp and do it. Do it like mid-length and out. Because it could, the calyx could actually poke up more if you go too short.
Okay.
And you could do it all around. I feel like he's nice and blended. I don't really have to do that. Okay. So, take these little trimmers around the ears. Okay, can you sit up nice and tall? And then relax, and then sit so still. Can you be as still as a statue? Okay, show me your statue. And then square around the ear. Just kind of etch out. The ear is so tricky. I like to pull the ear slightly down like that so I can see it. You could definitely carve a nice hole right here. That's where most people do. And so I push the ear down, and I'm so careful just right here to make sure it's nice and curved and not etched super straight, and then you have a hole right here. I use a comb. I don't know how else to get it as even. But some people can't really do both.
Yeah.
I've been doing this for a while, so.
Okay.
Let's go right here. Same thing. Nice and straight on that ear. If you want a cleaner line around the hairline, kind of get that straight off. You're doing so good. You're almost done. He has a little cowlick right here that pushes back, so I like to push that hair forward so I can get these little hairs. Okay, and then do you want the back like square or round or
whatever you think?
I think he can get away with anything. I like square personally, but
okay,
I can do kind of square with rounded edges.
Let's
okay, look down, Taylor.
Let's do square.
You're doing great.
Square is good.
I think it's nice and masculine,
yes,
in my opinion. I don't like super harsh edges, especially with cowlix anyway, so I don't do like a really crazy point on my square. So I have them look down, and it depends on where they move, so it can change. So go ahead and look straight, and I'm gonna have them look straight. And then I'm gonna look at it again and cut it again with him looking straight. Just to make sure I didn't miss any little hairs, just depending on where he looks. Good.
Stay still, bud.
You're doing great. Oh, he looks so good. Let me see. I can get a better way. Oh, that's perfect. Oh, you look so good. Let's put some product.
Okay, so I'm using like a matte clay paste. So I just did like a pea size at first, rubbed it in my hands really, really good so I have no clumps. And then I'm just gonna put it like everywhere, all throughout his entire head. And I use the last of my product on my hands to get the very front. And then I just really grab it.
Okay.
And pull it back, especially if you're going to do like a pulled back lip. Especially if he has calyx, you're really going to work on that to go back. So I like to push this forward and this back kind of to like a little point right here, because his calyx wants to go forward right here.
Okay.
But that's what I do with most of his hair anyway. Oh,
you're looking so good.
Okay, after I do that, I go through and just push down like laser here. And then I'm gonna blow dry it for just extra strength.
Okay, I'm just gonna get a shot of this.
Yeah.
That's what you use,
that's
right?
That's Architecture by L'Oreal Professional. Okay. It's my favorite. And then I just blow dry this front, especially if it's not gonna stay.
Okay.
I even have spray it. After.
Okay.
What? Okay, so I'm leaving it partially wet right now. Because if you blow dry his calyx, then it's not wet.
Okay.
So just don't touch that. If you're gonna put homemade, just do it however the calyx lane, like.
So we saw there. So is this the same thing you used before?
Or this is the same thing.
Okay.
And then I go through after it's dry, and I just kind of do the pieces that the finishing touch.
Okay.
Like his front.
Go ahead and look straight, and you're almost done.
You're almost done. You're looking so good. It's kind of pushed up into the side. This is the picture.
Oh, yes.
The picture that we had.
Look up.
What do you think?
Look up and smile. Tyler. Look at me. You look so cute. Good job.